Hello everybody, it's Catherine Kazishian, Yoga Cat here from Cat's Clinic. And today we're practicing a pose called Constructive Rest. It's an alternative resting pose to Shavasana or Corpse Pose. And I find that this one is particularly helpful when my lower back is feeling tight or tense, or my pelvis is maybe a little bit off of alignment. It's really great for anyone with scoliosis, hip issues, people that sit in chairs a lot, have tight lower backs, runners, people with tight hamstrings, because lying prone, or rather supine, flat out with the legs straight, there can be a pulling in the low back that may not be comfortable. So using this alternative constructive rest pose is a great option to have in your toolkit. And the way I set it up is that I have my blanket folded already, waiting for my head and neck. And then I have an extra little mat square because I have a concavity, a little bit of an unevenness in my lumbar that I want to support with support so that I'm resting and those tight muscles can release. To come into the pose, bending the knees with the feet flat and bring the hands behind, slowly come down on the elbows. What I like to do is use my thumbs to slide down the flesh of the low back so that I roll down and I become really long in the lower back area. Now you may find the clothes rolled with you and you need to adjust that a little bit. That's fine. Then I walk the feet out almost to the edge of the mat so that the legs can fall in towards each other. The knees fall together and the bones hold each other up. So the muscles in the legs can completely relax here. The groin can relax, the buttocks can relax. We want to get as relaxed as possible. So I'm not holding my legs up, I'm letting the bones do it. Some people find that this angle is not great, so they can put a support in there, a little yoga mat or a soft yoga block or a soft pillow, something that won't hurt when it falls out. So then I check my pelvic alignment. Let's see, I'm not tipping forward, I'm not tipping back. Find more or less a neutral place where my hip bones feel even, my inner groin muscles feel soft. And then I check my lower back. So I want to have my natural lumbar lower back curve away from the floor, but I don't want to be overarched. And I feel I found that place, and I still feel that the right side is further away from the floor than the left, and that's my typical pattern. So I fold up my square and tuck it in a little bit to have support there. So these tight muscles have support, they can relax. Mostly they just grip, grip, grip. So I want to let them know, hey, you can release too. Then we're going to roll and tuck the shoulders under one at a time, draw them down away from the ears. You can use the mat to reach down. That helps the neck get really long. And lift the head from the back of the head, lift the head, tuck the chin in to the center of the chest, and then lower the head back down. So the center of the back of the skull is facing the floor, touching the blanket, and my eyes are straight up to the ceiling. Now what I feel is I could actually have a little more support under the neck. So I roll up the blanket a little bit because I want to support my natural cervical curve. And then we need to adjust the arms once more. Let the arms be a comfortable distance away from the body to allow for the ribs to expand with the breath. Take a few soft breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. Inhale again. Through the nose, out through the mouth. And one more time. Sighing it out and softly closing the eyes. Maybe using an eye wrap or an eye pillow or an extra blanket over top to stay warm. And resting in this pose for as long as it's comfortable. Walk the feet together, Take the support out. Lift the arm, roll to the side, resting on the side for a few breaths. Feel any shifts or changes in the body. Stretch the top leg out. Bonus stretch if this is your concave side. Reach the arm up. Breathe in. Then place that hand in front of the chest. Keep the head heavy, chin tucked in. And slide using the arms to press up. So my head is the last thing that comes up. My neck stays soft, my lower back stays soft. And that's constructive rest position. Thanks for joining me. For more tips like this, check my other YouTube videos or look in my book, Scoliosis Undone, which is available on my website, www.yogacat.ca. That's Catherine Kazician, also known as Yoga Cat. Thanks for joining me today. Namaste.